Hello, we are Technology Enhanced Assessment ML Web Team. This is our team: Dr. Sarah, Dr. Amal, Dr. Dina, Dr. Muhammad, Dr. Ashraf, and me, Nancy, with our amazing advisor, Professor Amal Hashish. We have a wrapping up message for you, dear fellows, for the Technology Enhanced Assessment course. We are Group 12, Track 2 of ML Web. This was our action plan for the 3 weeks of the course with the three objectives of whole the course. We hope we have achieved them throughout the implementation. During the first week, our objectives were to define technology-enhanced assessment to describe methodology and benefits of it. We have received many amazing contributions from our brilliant fellows, and the wrapping up for your inputs are in the following seconds. Don't ask what the technology can offer you, rather what the pedagogy needs, Gilly Salmon.
Technology-enhanced assessment is a broad term that encompasses the diverse methods by which technology can be used to support the management and delivery of assessment. Technology-enhanced assessment doesn't mean simply replacing existing assessment WIH digital version, but rather making use of technology to tackle some of the operational and pedagogic issues of assessment. Technology-enhanced assessment has many benefits, as reducing test cost, improving the scoring process, providing flexible test schedules, providing prompt diagnostic reports. Also, it provides an automatic grading. They are also reusable. They also offer a wider range of tasks and activities. The methodology of technology-enhanced assessment includes online multiple-choice questionnaire for formative or summative assessments, also self-assessment of a project work via a reflecting blog. There is a huge scope for the use of technology to enhance both the delivery and management of assessment, including using video to deliver feedback.
During the second week,
our objectives were to design an innovative D method and to align it to the current COVID-19 era. We have received many creative and innovative ideas from our marvelous fellows, and hear the wrap-up of their contributions. Recent advances in information technology have paved the way for using new techniques in assessment and evaluation. However, the challenges for using technologies in assessment has more to do with how to make meaningful use of these technologies than getting to grip with how the tools work. As concerns implementation, a six-step approach model is proposed to develop and implement a successful technology-enhanced assessment. The first step, introducing computer-based assessment to both staff and students. The second step, using an established item bank. The third step, ensuring adequate infrastructure. The fourth step, developing computer-based assessment software. The fifth step, piloting computer-based assessment and preparing for untoward incidents. The last step, evaluating the exam.
And finally, we reached our last station in the third week.
The COVID-19 pandemic has generated unprecedented challenges for the assessment of medical education, resulting in a tremendous shift towards technology-enhanced assessment methods. Hopefully, COVID-19 pandemic will dwindle one day, that we might resume our regular lives in which online education and e-assessment were accessories and the traditional methods were cornerstone. For the preparation of this day that is free from COVID-19, we need to combine technology-enhanced assessment methods with the previously regularly used assessment context in their institution.
Here is the ideal framework for the e-assessment method.
To criticize any e-assessment method, you need to evaluate it as concerns scalability, security, access and usability, feedback features, personalization, cost, interoperability, and also regards variety of design options.
We have to get the greatest benefits from the tools offered by technology to offer the best quality of assessment. We hope we have reached your expectations about the course. Thank you all so much for your valuable contributions throughout the course. This video was prepared by Dr. Nancy Husseini.